Alright guys, so I promised I was going to show my bearings when I did my camshaft bearings and rocker arms. So I wanted to show you guys the damage that was done, and this motor only had about 600,000 miles when I did this, and it had a tune for over, Rossi's tune for over, I want to say 125,000 miles. So I changed my oil at 12 to 14,000 miles, in between 12 and 14,000 miles. I only use Rotella, no oil additives whatsoever. I don't believe in it, and I will never use it in my engine. So, all right, let's start with a valve camshaft. This is the camshaft that actually drives your intake, exhaust valves, and your engine brake also. So we'll take a look at him. Just for all you guys that maybe read my article on Rossi.com under Bosco Corner, I talked about a camshaft and for the valves. That camshaft actually does not supply oil to the bearings. Bearings get their oil from the head itself. And as you'll see, every single one of them has a hole, oil passage hole, where the oil will go through. And a result of that, you will see the bearing wear. I'll try to make that the best possible for you guys. Matter of fact, I'll just grab it and I'll try to show it to you. So this is the damage that was done to it. Some copper, and this is the first one. So this one sits all the way in front of the engine. All right, this is the second one. It actually looks a lot better. Not much wear. It's okay for 600,000, and then it just gets better from here. This one, just fine. For 600,000, that's actually very good. This one, a lot better. And just a little bit of wear on this one. So, not too bad. And this is the last one. So the first and last are the only ones that have some copper. All rest, we're okay. So you see what I'm saying here, you'll see the pattern now. So I'm still talking about camshaft that drives your valves, engine brake, and this is the side of the engine that actually supplies the oil to the bearings through the head and not through the camshaft. Alright, now I'll show you guys the injector, which are these big bearings. This is the injector camshaft bearing, and just look at the damage in this. This is the first one, right? Not so bad, but no, I don't like it, so this is the reason I changed them. This is number two, and you'll notice something. Alright, so the first one, you'll see it has a oil hole, so the oil comes from the head inside the cam, and then it travels through them to the middle, which is this one right here. And you'll see this, not much wear on this one, a little bit there on the end, and that's it. And then check this one out. You see the middle of it, all that crap that's in the middle has traveled through the camshaft and into the bearing. Now, lack of oil through it, and lack of oil pressure, and also the crap that get clogged up inside the cam has to go in there, and you see the damage it does. And you can see this one too, and you can see some pretty deep scuff marks on this one. Now this one also does not get the oil supply from the head. All these bearings get their oil from the camshaft itself. Pretty decent damage on this one.
And then also the last one, which gets its oil from the head. See the through the middle where the oil comes in? It's fine, and then on the edges, it's has somewhere. So, if you read the document that I wrote, you'll definitely get a better picture of it now, of what I was talking about. And then, for all you guys that wanted to see the flaking camshaft, well, I couldn't bring a camshaft with me, but I brought the next best thing, so.
Alright, so let's talk about a rocker arm for your injector. A lot of people talk about flaking camshafts, flaking. This is what flaking actually is. You can't really tell, and the video is not so good. But I'll try to do my best to kind of zoom in on this. It just won't work as good. But this is the damage. And this just gets worse and worse and worse by the time. And it'll create a lot of damage in your engine if this is not taken care of. So that's that. Now, while I'm here, for all you guys that are wondering how this works, the bushings, they were okay. Not so bad. But this is how that oil travels. So it goes through the shaft, it gets oil from the head, goes inside the rocker arm shaft, goes through here. You'll see the oil port right here. See the oil port? It'll go through there and come right out of this tiny itty bitty hole. So alright, get back to what I was talking about. Sorry guys, I had a phone call. So the oil travels through there, comes out of this little hole. So think about it, high oil temperatures mixed with soot and plus irregular oil changes, and this stuff will clog up, and it'll definitely do some damage to your engine. As you can see, like I bought my truck when it had 480,000. And I took care of it really good since I have it, but the damage was already done, and there was not much I can really do. But this is it. I mean, not much damage. I done all this by myself, and I made a tool to pop all these bearings out. A friend of mine had a good puller for the camshaft gear. That you'll find out that's probably going to be the hardest thing to take off from this engine when you start disassembling it. That's about it. I made my own timing wedge kit. I didn't want to spend $300 and some with Cummins when I actually can make my own. So I made my own, done everything, and so far so good. I mean, my truck runs good. I think I need to adjust the valves one more time. But other than that, that's it. So that's the damage, and I did replace one more rocker arm, and I'll show you guys why. This is why. This is the only damage that was on this rocker arm, but it'll start with this, and you know, it'll be a lot worse after a while. So when I was in there, I was like, well, I'm already here, might as well replace it. And this thing is not cheap. I think it's like $200 for one of these rocker arms. So yeah, definitely some good money. So that's all. I hope I answered some of you guys' questions, or at least show you guys what it will actually look like when you pull it out. Now I will mention that the guy that helped me out, he worked with Cummins for quite some time now, and he's pretty knowledgeable. He's told me that this probably is the cleanest ISX he's seen so far. The cleanest inside. He said he hasn't seen one yet this clean. So I don't know why. I don't know if it's something I had to do with it, but I think mostly it's the tune, though. It keeps the truck running really, really clean and really efficient. My oil, after 14,000 miles, it's still
golden. Like, it looks like gold when you pour it out. It's clean, and people don't even believe me. Like, people on a truck stop will look at it and be like, yeah, you just changed it. But it's definitely a truth. I mean, you guys, if you have your tune done, you guys can vouch for me. So that's about it. If you guys have any questions, let me know, and I'll try to answer it as best as I can. All right, guys, take care.
See ya till next time.